Now that we've covered activity content transitions, let's move on to shared element transitions. Let's start off by taking a look at why they're useful. Now, when changing the state of your UI, motion can help you to explain that change, as well as focus your attention on the content that matters. So in this example, the album cover remains throughout the transition between an artist screen and an album screen, smoothly moving into place. The transition is organized around the object that you selected and it unfolds from your touch. It helps to keep you oriented. We call this a shared element transition as the album cover is shared across the two states. Even if your UI doesn't include rich imagery for you to transition between states, you can use the same principles to convey navigational relationships. In this example, clicking on an item in the list causes it to lift up, forming its own surface, and then expand into place. This reinforces the parent-to-child relationship that you're drilling down into an item. The motion guides the user between the two states. We can also take advantage of this advanced paper material, which can transform its size and shape and position. This helps us to move between states within a screen, not just across screen boundaries. So in this example, clicking on an event in your calendar, the material lifts up into its own separate surface and then transforms into the event details page. These examples all help to provide continuity between different states in your UI to create a more understandable experience.